So, Farron, we're still in the wake of the Democratic debate, amongst other things that's happening in the Democratic Party, and we've discussed those. But I want to touch on Bernie Sanders coming out of the debate. You know, the polls, despite what I guess the message that Joe Biden may or may not have gotten, the polls clearly showed that the debate was a win for both Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton, and basically a loss for Joe Biden. Now, one of the things that I thought was really astute by Bernie Sanders when he came out of the debate earlier this week, he announced that he's going to be giving a big speech on what is democratic socialism. And coming out of that debate, it occurred to me that there were basically two things that Bernie Sanders had to address. One is the knee-jerk reaction by Americans to the words democratic socialism. I don't think he did a good enough job in explaining what that is. And it's not terribly complicated. People want to know what a democratic socialist is. A democratic socialist is the person who came up with the idea of Social Security. Democratic socialist is the person who supports Medicare. Democratic socialist is the guy who came up with the idea of a free public school education. Democratic socialists are the people who brought you a free higher education 30, 40 years ago in various states around the country, and so on. It's fairly straightforward. It's not as mysterious or exotic, I think, as some Americans make it out to be. And also, a democratic socialist is someone who wants to strengthen and expand Social Security. He came out with that plan this week, very specifics on how he intends to raise the cap, use that cap as a means in which to change the way cost of living is calculated for elderly people. We know for a long time the Department of Labor has done some, has run sort of basically experimental inflation measures for elderly people that take into account things like drug costs and medical costs, which tend to increase at a higher rate than inflation. Because frankly, let's face it, if you're a senior, your costs are not the same as if you're someone who is in their 40s or their 20s or their 50s. And so you got Bernie Sanders out there pushing that, this idea of explaining to the American public what a socialist is. And there's also the other thing that he's got to do, I think, in the next debate is to begin to talk about his record of getting things done. You know, Farron, as well as anybody, that Bernie Sanders has been involved in actual legislation and reform as a legislature. And despite the fact that it's very hard for independents, supposedly, to get stuff passed, he has figured out both in the House and as a senator how to do that very thing.
He has. And, you know, just to take it back one second, you know, you explained the democratic socialism, all of the great plans that have been put forward by democratic socialists. The problem, the reason socialism, that word itself, has such a negative connotation with the American public is the fact that we have a right-wing media out there that unfortunately is, you know, they have higher ratings than any other media outlet, unfortunately, but they get out there and they equate socialism to fascism. They equate socialism to Nazism or to communism. And people eat it up. These Republicans eat it up. They spread the word on Facebook and Twitter, and they share short videos of this. And it's an absolute lie, but this right-wing media machine keeps pumping it out there, and that's why it's still alive. If you
didn't
have
it. We should be clear, too, that if you poll the words socialism and capitalism, the answers you get back in terms of approval of those words for people under the age of 30 or 35 is radically different than what you get for people over the age of 45. Under the age of 30 in this country, the word socialism actually polls better than the word capitalism. So it may be the case that Fox News continues to associate I don't know, all sorts of horrible happenings with the words democratic socialist. But the reality is that it's really only edifying maybe positions that older people are predisposed to because they grew up during the Cold War. And, you know, everything that that even was even remotely associated with the Soviet Union is considered, I don't know, verboten. But the fact of the matter is that he has passed amendments on child labor, increasing funding for people living in low income and living in poverty for heating, fighting corporate welfare bills. In the Senate, he was involved in greening the U.S. government and amendments to protect our troops, restricting the bailout to protect U.S. workers in 2009, helping veterans, kids. The thing is, Bernie Sanders has a long history of legislating, of actually working with people across the aisle. And this is something that I think that he's got to go out there and promote in the future.